Okay, welcome back everybody. One thing to note is that if you're going to use this method, it requires Adobe After Effects CC 2018 or later. If you don't have that, I'm sorry. You'll have to either download a trial version from Adobe or find another method, because the script that comes with this is only packaged in CC 2018. That said, let's go ahead and get started. I will create a new comp, and we're gonna just call this bounce, and I'm gonna go with 1920, 1080 frame rate, whatever you want it, and duration. I'm gonna go with 3 seconds. I'm gonna go ahead and start by pasting in these color swatches. I find it easier to go ahead and create the bouncing ball first, and then we'll go back and create the elastic line below it. So I will go over here and hit Q, or just go to the ellipse tool, and I'm gonna choose that. If we hit shift and drag, we can draw the shape. That is a little bit big, so let me go back on that a little bit. Okay, something I always do when I'm drawing a circle on the screen like that is you'll notice that you have your global transform, like position and rotation, etc., and then you have your ellipse transform. And if you don't zero out the position here, sometimes it creates problems and the anchor point and different things on the global just don't look exactly right. Sometimes you'll have the anchor point way up here or something like that. It's a little bit wonky. So I just go ahead and zero that out, and it's a good starting place. We do want to add a stroke, and so there's already one there. Increase the stroke size just a bit. And if we want to give this a little something different, we can always go down here to dashes and hit that once. And then actually, if you hit it again, you can kind of make these go out a little bit and increase the size of these dashes. And now you have these dashes, and the reason why is because I want to apply some rotation. I think it just kind of gives a little something extra, and that's the only way you can see it. Let me change the name of this to ball. So we hit the stopwatch there and then go to the end, and we will hit the stopwatch again, and then we're going to go right here in between. In my case, it's about 115, and we are just going to drag this up, and I would shift and drag. I highly recommend that. So we are going to select all those keyframes and hit F9 to easy ease those, and let's play this. And as you might expect, it doesn't look good. So let's go over here to the graph editor and make sure you have speed graph selected, and which we do. So the way to read the graph editor is understanding that this represents pixels per second. So here's your time and here's the pixels per second. Well, when you're working with something that's going to look elastic, you're going to have most of your inertia there at the beginning. So let's go right there, and then once it gets up to the top, it's gonna go way down, so almost to a halt. Okay, same. And then we also pull it here. That's our other handlebar at the other side. And here at the end, when the elastic is kind of pulling down, it's not gonna come to a quick halt. It's gonna sort of go very slowly and ease into it. So let's see if that kind of works for us. All right, and I may have gone too far on that, so let me go back here a little bit, and you sort of just play with it just to see if you can get the look you want. Okay, that works for me. It looks like it's in constant motion. It doesn't come to a complete stop up there. Next thing we want to do is also add a rotation keyframe. So we go over here, we go to the end again, add another keyframe, go here to the middle, and I would say just kind of make it go about 35 or so. And oh yeah, we want to go ahead and hit F9 to easy ease those. You don't have to do rotation. I just add it here so we can kind of get a sense of different types of movement. I think it adds a little bit to the realism of it. So there's that. Next thing we do is deselect our ball shape there, and we hit the letter G for the pen tool, and Now we just create a line. So maybe go slightly above this ball if you're there at the beginning of the timeline. Hit click or click this. And then we're going to click. And this time we're going to drag to the right if you're going left to right. And then one more right here at the end. Okay? We can go ahead and kill the fill. Okay, and then go over here and let's go ahead and choose a color. I'm going to go with something a little brighter like that. Maybe we can make this a little bit thicker. And we will just name this line. Go down here to our shape. Let's look at our stroke. Only thing I want to do is just change this to a round cap. I just think it's a little better looking. So here's the method I use to create a line when I'm using a shape path. This is much easier than moving those individual paths one at a time, if you know what I'm talking about. It's not easy to get in there and grab this and drag it down. And also we're going to be adding an expression to give it the bounce. It's just way easier to go ahead and do it this method. If you go to window, you may not know about this, but there is a script here called create nulls from paths. This is bundled with After Effects CC 2018 and later, and in my case I already have it docked over here. And what that's going to do is it's going to take our three points right here, here, and here, and add a null to them. So let me go ahead and hit that, and you'll see we have three nulls right here. The one in the middle is the one we're concerned most with. I'm going to hit V to go back to my pointer tool. And if you don't know what a null object is, it's this invisible layer that you can parent other things to, and you can apply expressions to and things like that. And it has tons of value as far as controlling what other layers, those visible layers, do. So that's what that is. Okay, from now on we don't have much control over our line anymore. You really can't get in here and move these points. See, I'm trying to drag. It doesn't want me to do that because we have parenting going on. If I hit double E, you'll see for the expression path, you have all this code right here. If you go over here to the effect control, you'll see that you have this effect that's been applied. So basically those three paths are definitely parented to the nulls. So I'm gonna hit P for position, and I'm gonna go down here and try to do my best to eyeball this. I can hit the space and it's going to give me the handle tool, something like that. This is the only tedious part, but after this we're going to be using an expression. We just need to get this thing leveled up, okay? And so I can actually just hit the up arrow and move it. Go down one more frame, go up a little bit. I think it's easier than using the mouse. You can even shift an up arrow. Let me hit P on this other one to find out how far up we need to go. We need to go up to 752 pixels. So one more frame down. And I think if I just type 752, we can probably be there. Now we need to go back where it's coming down. And it starts hitting it right there. So we hit the keyframe, we go down one frame. Let's go all the way back out and take a look at what we got. I'm thinking that's pretty passable. And if you're wondering why I'm not doing any squash and stretching the ball, I just didn't want to drag this tutorial out. I just wanted to teach this one concept. So let's give this an elastic look. Now, I'm not an expression guru. Let me give credit where credit is due. And I found this on Harry Frank's website called Gray Machine. And if you don't know who Harry Frank is, he's a well-known motion graphic designer and teacher, and he works for Red Giant, doing a lot of their tutorials, highlighting a lot of their different plugins, things like that. So I do give him credit for doing a tutorial a while back, And I will put a link in the description to his tutorial. I think it was called like his favorite expressions or something like that. And I will also put the code for this down below. The reason why I like this one the best is one up here at the top, you have your three attributes of a bounce, which are basically your amplitude. That is how much up or down motion is going to be applied to something, the frequency, how quickly it goes, and then the decay, how quickly it dives back down and just becomes that straight line. The second thing I do like about this is it's triggered. So as soon as it detects a keyframe, it begins this. It begins the bounce. Otherwise, and if you didn't have keyframe triggering, the bounce would begin just as soon as you hit play, okay? And that's not gonna work for us. And then you have all this other stuff, which sometimes I don't have a very good explanation for. So we're going to copy this, hit Command or Control C. We're gonna go over here, and we are gonna hit Option or Alt on this position, and we're gonna hit that stopwatch, okay? And we are going to paste this in here. And there it is, there's all our code. And in fact, let me go ahead and make our amplitude a little bit higher, just 2, and see if that works for us. Okay, and let's go ahead and get it started. So I hit play. All right, and that looks pretty good. If you start playing with the amplitude too much, you can really start messing things up and it's gonna lose any look it's gonna have. For instance, if you change it to 5, now it's going beyond that ball and it completely loses the realism of the two. So let me hit Command Z or Control Z. And it doesn't have to just be a regular line that you can apply this elastic to. You can apply it to any of these shapes here, you know, if you want to apply it to a rounded rectangle or rectangle or whatever. It's the same, pretty much the same method, however you want to apply that bounce. But this is the simplest application of it all. Another thing I do like about this is since we already have our expressions and our parenting in place, you can come up here and, for instance, here is our shape. Let's say if I wanted to decorate this and make it look a little bit better, let me hit Command Shift H. And I can hit Command or Control D on that shape there. I can hit our eyedropper and let's just grab this green here. And of course we see nothing. Now remember, I don't have control up here to change my path transformation, but I can kind of go down here a little bit. And let's say if you just wanted to make a slight little double layer, let's go ahead and make this a little bit darker. So that way you don't have to redo this all over again, because like I said, the parenting has already taken place on this shape layer here. So that's another thing I kind of like about this. Again, I hope that's something you found helpful. I work a lot with shape layers, so this is something I utilize quite a bit in my work. And I think you will too, because it does kind of have so many applications to it to add that realism to it. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you can follow me if you want to. Leave a like or comment, anything like that. I'm always available to answer any questions you have. Thank you so much and have fun animating.